the president, uh-huh. but he's not the president himself
All
speaking.
Right. So
I think it's important that uh-huh. his personal Twitter uh-huh. handle, he must be held responsible for it.
So is there a need for the president here to actually verify before it's been put out there? Because, I mean, he's standing, he's speaking, but he can't tweet. So should his team wait for him to finish speaking, then he verifies, then he's like, okay, go ahead and publish this?
Yes, I don't think that there is room for these kind of missteps uh-huh. when it comes to the highest office in the land. It's a poor show. Now, if we look at examples from across the world, you look at perhaps the White House, they, under President Donald Trump now, they have created a specific office, a Director of Strategic Communications. Now, this person still works under the Director of Communications in the White House. However, they have a direct reporting line to the president himself. So in a case like this, whether the president, he should be aware of what's being said for and on behalf of himself and the constitutional office that he holds.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Now, let's move away from, the Twitter handle of...
Just a bit.
Okay.
I think what Oyeri is talking and giving example of the U.S., I think the U.S. is a worse example.
Because of what Trump tweets.
Trump has also been branded a liar. Because sometimes he speaks things that don't exist. Yet some things are being tweeted.
And some
you
of
cannot
these
actually know
are
what
actually,
he is saying.
It's,
and I think the United States communication strategy is worse. I think because of the
so is ours better? When you're saying that is...
I would actually say ours is better. Because you see... The U.S. has, and Muluka says that the presidency as an institution uh-huh. must be protected at all times. Individuals who occupy those offices. That's why you see in the U.S. with the advanced communication strategies and plans, the president is still branded a liar.
So let me ask you, gentlemen.